Thank you so much. So we move on to the last two sessions for the day. So first we have a startup pitch and followed by a very interesting session on the investment perspective in retail tech. So for the startup pitch, I invite Abhinav from Purple. And Mr. Sunil Nair from Spar. Purple, you might be remembering, so he was one of the startups which was presented by, he was showcased as a startup connect by Mr. Biani in his presentation. So over to you, Abhinav. Yeah, thank you.
Thanks, everyone. You should have this. Thanks, everyone. Thanks, Rohit, for having us over. So we're going to tell you about, I think, the theme for this retail tech track in this event was, I think the first word that you see on the website was self-checkout. So, and that's what we kind of do primarily for a living. And we've been doing it with an India-focused way because self-checkout is like a very much talked about thing outside of India, massive adoption in the UK, Australia, US, and many other places. We have been really tweaking it all this while for the last 2 years and implementing it in the various retail formats that we have in India. I have along with me Mr. Sunil Nair. He is the CIO of Spar India. I'm sure all of you must have shopped at Spar some or the other time.
Good afternoon, everyone. I know it's a boring time to discuss technology here, but I think just to start with, what we are trying to present today is, you know, the customer dynamics today have changed where, you know, the shopping as far as grocery retailing is concerned. I think the slides that follows here is one of the dimensions that we are trying to capture from an experience customer enhancement perspective. I think it will be interesting to share some details about, you know, what the tech product offers, and from a customer perspective, how do we look at this technology?
Yeah. Next. Yeah, so what we primarily do is we have built a self-checkout platform. It's like a very, very open system, typically built for the consumer requirements in India, focusing on how can we ensure that nobody stands in lines. Like, I'm sure all of you would have gone to the various retail stores, specifically the grocery stores, and lines is a norm. Like, if you go in weekend, if you go in peak hours, you will have to stand in lines. So how do we kind of try to avoid that was what the theme of this whole thing was. And what did we figure out? That there's a lot more that can be done than just skipping the line. This solution of self-checkout across the world, if you see outside of the world, happens on multiple channels. If you see probably a Tesco, if you see a Walmart, all of them will have like a dedicated self-checkout kiosk, self-checkout counter sort of a thing where a person can go and self-checkout themselves. The model in India is very different, and that's what we kind of have proved with the data that we have aggregated in the last 2 years. It all happens on mobile phone. India is like a real mobile first country. And though when this whole transaction happens on the mobile phone of the consumer, the kind of engagement that we can drive for the retailer is massively better than any other platform on which it can happen. And over time, the customer gets a much better connect with the store, starts browsing content about the store, about products, about things that is peculiar to that store, and then starts engaging more and more, which finally adds to the benefit of the store. So this is how it kind of works. And what we do is primarily we work with retailers like Spar, and we implement self-checkout at their stores. Now, any customer can download this app and discover the stores. Once you're in this store, you can physically go around shopping, pick up any item from the shelf. This is like primarily targeted to modern retail. So all the items will have like a barcode on top of them. You can scan the barcode using the app. We have like an integration with the systems in the back end. We'll tell you what is the price, what is the promotion, and every single thing about the product if you want to know. You can browse all of that. If you want to buy, you can add it to your mobile cart. Repeat the whole process for all the bunch of items that you're going to buy. Once you're done, you can just check out and pay in the app itself. You'll get your digital invoice and you can straight away go out of the store.
It's not that complicated as it sounds. The point is, you know, from a customer perspective, I think, you know, you have an app, you have a choice to shop, especially when you're buying at grocery stores, you know, even one or three people in a queue is a queue actually. And when you're buying one product or two products, it makes a big difference. What we saw is when we implemented this technology, there is a set of users who are actually into this kind of, an experience. So there are techie crowds, which I call between 20 to 30. I have seen age group of around 60 to 70, you know, guys using this kind of technology. So there is a need for this kind of solution that needs to come out. I think Purple actually fits in there from that mode. Not because I'm working with them, but as a customer, I am saying, you know, it's more important that the customers have, I mean, our online customers or be it offline customers are very positive about this this introduction of so-called technology in the space where, you know, we're talking about in India. And I think it's a way, I mean, it's just a started, it's a journey started right now, but it's a right journey. And in the timing could never be right.
Yeah. I think it was just the perfect time. And probably I'll go back to 2 years, right? When we were trying to implement this for the Indian masses, we always knew in the back of our minds that India is a mobile country. But self-checkout doesn't work on mobile phones anywhere else. And self-checkout is like a very, very old concept. It's like 15 years old for folks in US, for folks in UK and so on. But we, at the back of our hearts, somehow like always knew that it's not going to work on mobile. It's not going to work on anything else except for mobile phones in India. Which is why we kind of implemented it in both the modes. We took a leap of faith and said that, yes, things will connect well and it'll work fine on mobile phones, as well as follow the tradition way of doing it around self-checkout counters and kiosks and all of that. What we figured out over time was the adoption for app was phenomenally more. Like you can say 99% of the transactions are happening via app. And there's no specific push for that. India is just an app country. India is just a mobile country. So we kind of validated that. And now the model looks a lot more, I would say, very simple from an implementation perspective, how the whole thing has changed and all the unknowns have been kind of figured out in the last 2 years. And now we are like just deploying this at scale. So in the whole thing, like if you see probably how the self-checkout scenario works, it was very, very cumbersome. Porting that to a real mobile phone and then making it work with the user engagement perspective, making a sparse store be so accessible, because I mean the kind of SKUs they have, the kind of data that they have, right? It's a lot for a mobile phone to process. That's where the whole technology angle of it comes into picture. How can it really become accessible? Because earlier it was running on like super heavyweight computers. Now it's running on like any small $4,000 mobile phone. So porting that whole was the digital transformation that we have done. And over time, it's only becoming better and better. So this is how we kind of started. And Spar was actually the first of the retailers who we went out and kind of started working with. This is roughly around 2 years back. And I would really thank Sunil for giving us that platform to kind of roll this out. And if you see today, this has been a long journey. And we kind of do self-checkouts at all their prime locations. And almost this is like an unbelievable number. 20% of the store sales for Spar happens via self-checkout. That's like almost 1/5 of the people there are transacting via that. And it's increasing every day. We have some more stats around the kind of engagement that we have driven for people. The customers who are on the self-checkout platform retain a lot more with the customers, I'm sure Sunil can...
No, I think it's very important that we look into this key KPIs, what we're talking about. The most important KPI for me at this moment of time is the average checkout time. Now, traditionally, when you see point-of-sale software, you know, you traditionally taken around 40 to 50 seconds. And now here we are talking about 16 seconds. That is, you know, 80% reduction in overall time. That's a big, big time. Changeover. Second is very important is the retention part. You know, what is important from our cycle is this tech for just for tech purpose, or you know, is there merit to what we are doing? So what we found out is, you know, a lot of customers are repeating their purchase in this mode, which means, you know, there is some method to madness, honestly speaking. So this is where it comes to. Third thing, very important, what comes out of this is the capex part is actually reduced. When we use this kind of model, today if you see in a hypermarket, supermarket, traditionally you have this point of sale machines. For that matter, we have an average of around 40 to 45 POS machines across the stores. Now imagine this can be replicated with handheld devices, second, mobiles coming into. So mobiles can be playing in two fronts. One could be from a customer perspective, and I can also give this to my sales staff, which can act as, we call it as assisted self-checkouts. So it could be direct self-checkout, which is a customer can manage the transaction through his or her perspective, or it could be an assisted checkout. But it gives me flexibility to do transactions both ways. Now, can I use this as case studies to do different types of transactions? For example, can I create a small store where my capex on technology will not be that high? For that matter, you know, you technically speaking, I mean, Amazon Pay and Go, I don't know. Is it possible? Yeah, it's possible. One. Second, is it possible for me to enhance other things? Like, you know, we say marketing related activities. You know, we say personalization is a new term that is being used. If you have this app, can I do a lot of my private label sales there? Is it possible that way? I think a lot of things can be done. So I think what revolves around is it's not just the checkout thing. Once you get this entire piece solved, you are trying to resolve a lot of issues that a retailer will be facing today by this one app is what we're talking about.
I mean, yeah, at a high level, that's kind of what the whole thing is. And I would say one more thing which is still evolving is, right, that the number that you see, right, 0% printed invoices. So literally 1/5 of the printed invoices have been reduced from the store and the number is only increasing. And now it is in a digital form. In a digital form. Over time, when this adoption becomes much, much higher, that's going to be another revenue stream. We can probably upsell and cross-sell products there, which is going to generate alternate revenue for the store that they can't really generate today because they don't have the stock for it. So that digital engagement platform becomes like as simple as that invoice. I'm sure all of you would have seen at some time your moms, right? They really love looking through the invoices. When it happens on a digital digital platform, the kind of tweaking that you can do in that whole invoice page is like really phenomenal from a customer engagement standpoint. And you can tell them about everything that they missed buying today, and then they can go back and probably buy a multiple bunch of things on those fronts. So this is what, in a nutshell, we have kind of achieved so far. And we are like now almost at a place where we are ready for deploying this at scale, at masses. And we are kind of working with many other retailers. And obviously, Sunil has been guiding us for all this while. So that's kind of what the journey of self-checkouts has been. Probably we'll open it up for you guys if you guys have any thoughts or suggestions on the whole thing. And this is how we kind of imagine what the future of retail is going to be. Sure. Good question. I was kind of waiting for that. So in the same traditional way, I mean, how it works globally is that all of these catalogs, we operate on weight. So there's a weighing-based verification system. So when you do all the scanning of all the bunch of items, before you exit, there's a machine on which you have to keep all your items. And that machine has like a very active weight catalog of the whole bunch of items that you have bought. So he'll identify who you are, what you have bought. You put your items on the weighing balance, it kind of identifies and you can just go away. Now we are also building a layer on top of that around computer vision, which is also kind of scaling very fast, very quickly. And then it's going to be like a combined solution of both weight plus computer vision, which kind of prevents theft, which I would say is a very, very key angle since we are operating in India.
Yeah, the other way to put it simply is, you know, you can also use the security guys which are currently there and do a sampling of the entire merchandise. A, we can use it also as saying that, you know, if you have less than 5 merchandise to be purchased or less than 10, you know, can we use this? So we can do a 100% checking. A. B, we can always take the cash or, you know, we can do the billing wherever the customer is, not in it that he should be near the POS till. So we can use it less than 5, less than 10, use a security guard to check those things, and yet you will get, you know, a enhanced experience in the form of saying that, you know, it was a faster checkout.
What if somebody
wants to pay using cash? It is possible. That's where the concept of assisted checkout comes in, where, you know, the sales guy will carry the entire kind of pouch and everything. So we this is a model that is getting evolved as we speak. So yeah, we started with self-checkout, but the same concept is being used for assisted checkouts, which means I can give you that personalization. People are there who are not very convenient about scanning the QR codes, barcodes and all the stuff. So we can help them. So it's a kind of service we say, hello. So today we are trying to implement that as part of the customer loyalty program. So people who are, you know, shopping with us and we have the database, can we help them and give this specialized service? Yes, why not? So this tool is available for us to do that. Yeah.
But what we have figured out over time, yes, there are people who can collect your cash. But I mean, what data really says is that a customer who is tech savvy enough to really do this whole process will have its own cards and all of that saved. So, and Paytm is always linked. So probably it becomes like a very much more seamless transaction than cash. But again, from an implementation standpoint, it's doable.
Can we see Amazon go for India?
This is the Amazon Go for India. No, like, I mean, it's a much more tweaked and scaled up version of it. But if you probably, you should visit a Spar store, any of the ones in Bangalore, and you will get a very, very close experience to that.
So
yeah.
Is there the experience that we get, which we have seen with Amazon Go, is something practical in India?
I would vouch for it as a customer perspective, not from a technology cost perspective. Technology cost I can't afford when you say Amazon Go. But the point is, yeah, with this part, with the mobile part, I think we are pretty much there. If you ask me, if the key KPIs that is being followed at, you know, with those kind of Amazon Pay and Go model and what we are doing from here, it is matching from a KPI perspective. From a cost perspective, are we there? I think you can't compare that because, you know, it is more of analytics being thrown out, more of cameras, AI has been working out. This is a pretty much simple kind of interaction, good for Indian retailers at this point of time, and it serves a purpose. That's the more objective answer to it.
And honestly, if you look at what Amazon has been doing, right? I mean, actually, Amazon Go was launched just in the same timeline when we launched with Spar, roughly the same timeline, almost a bit more than 2 years back. So what they have done so far is this one store, that too, such a small one. So I would say Amazon Go at this stage, it's just a lab concept. It's a lot more to come further and evolve. To look from outside looks really, really beautiful. But is it scalable? Is it deployable? It's a long journey that they also would have to cover. And that too for mature markets like the US. Coming to India, I would say, is like not happening probably currently at the pace at which they're growing. So the model changes a bit, but the purpose, the reason remains the same. That's how probably we look at it, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. I would love to. So we are developing case studies. It cannot be direct fitment of what we're talking about. But yeah, what ideally as a customer, what you would love to have is one app, right? At the end of the day, it should be taking the entire journey. It can't be saying that I have a Spar India app for my e-commerce engine and a cash out, you know, self-checkout app for a, I mean, it could be a marketplace, it could be your own, but at the end of the day, the journey should be one. Definitely, yes, that's in pipeline. It's hard work from our side because as we speak, so we are not a technology company, right? You need to understand, be it Spar, be it, you know, Tesco, be it, you know, Walmart. We are not a technology company, we are a retail company. So we can give case studies to the technology companies to come out with saying that, look, this is the pain points of customers, you know, can you address this? So definitely, yes, this is in the plan. And I think that would be a good framework to work with from a one data centricity perspective, which means, you know, you have one set of data. And I would like to see one customer at the end of the day. Now, today, my data analytics goes for a toss because the moment an online customer shops in, I have a different variation of data. And the same customer if comes into my physical store for shopping, I have a different set of data to manage. So from back-end perspective also, I have a challenge integrating these two platforms. So it will be good for me from a customer perspective, end-user perspective to get this into one channel. I hope I have answered you.
Cool. I think we are out of time. Thanks so much, guys.
Thank you.
Yes, I'm sure you have more questions. Please take it offline. So Abhinav and Sunil would be around. Thank you so much, Abhinav and Sunil.